In this video, we're going to be taking a look at sharing and collaboration in Box. To begin sharing, you can go to tufts.box.com and log in with your Tufts username and password, which I've already done. And Box has been approved for many different types of content for sharing and for collaboration because of the security protections that are in place. And it is HIPAA and FERPA compliant, so that's a good thing to keep in mind. When you are sharing things in Box, just keep in mind that the content that you put in there and who it's shared with is ultimately your responsibility. So I'm putting up a URL on the screen for the Tufts Box use guidelines that you might want to take a look at if you'd like more information. But with Box, you can share your content with people who are in Tufts University as well as people who are outside of Tufts University. So be careful about what you share. So is there sensitive content there? And who you share it with? And really the recommendation for best practices is don't share something unless you absolutely need to. And try to share it with as few people as possible and really give them the minimum necessary permissions. And also keep in mind when you are setting up your sharing settings on folders in particular that when you share a folder, the settings that you apply are going to also apply to any subfolders and files that it contains. The sharing of files and folders in Box works in the exact same way. In your file list, next to each of your files and folders, when you move your mouse over them, you're going to see this share button pop up next to the more options button. And you'll also see that button when you're in something like the file preview window. But if you click on that, what's going to happen is it's going to bring up a share window where you're given two options. You can invite people to collaborate here, or you can enable a shared link. You can also use both of these things simultaneously if you'd like, and sometimes that's appropriate for convenience. But what you want to keep in mind is that the difference between these two, if you had to choose between one or the other, is that invitations to collaborate are potentially two-way streets, meaning that you can share content with people, and depending on how you set it up, they can edit that content and upload new content as well. Shared links, on the other hand, are a one-way street, so people who access content through shared links can only view the content and potentially download it if you give them that permission. To begin, we're going to take a look at inviting people to collaborate. To invite people to collaborate, I can begin by typing their names and email addresses into this box here. So, for example, I want to invite to this folder someone named John Jumbo. And as the names pop up, if you see it, you can select it. And you can keep doing that with all of your invitees. And once you have them listed, you have to decide on what permission level you'd like to give them. The default here is editor for files and folders, so be careful of that. If I click on this, it'll open up a drop-down where I can change that, and the available permissions for folders go all the way from co-owner all the way down to uploader, and they get more restrictive as you go down the list, with editor being the default once again. The recommendation is that you give people the fewest privileges necessary. So in this case, I maybe don't want to make John Jumbo an editor. He only needs to be able to preview documents that are in that folder, so I can make him and other people previewers. Once I've decided on that, I can type in a custom message here as well, and then I can go ahead and click on send. Keep in mind as you're doing this that because of the way that it's set up, you're going to have to invite people in batches. And what I mean by that is you would need to invite your editors in one batch and then send those out, invite your viewer uploaders in another batch and send those invites out, and so on and so forth. But once this is set up, you go ahead and click on send, and it's going to send those invites out, and you can start collaborating. Once that's set up, if I'm looking at this folder here, as you can see now, John Jumbo is listed as a previewer on that folder. And if I want to adjust my invitee's privileges or remove them from a particular item, I can click on this options button here and change their permissions or remove them. Or another way that you can do that is for that item, you can click on the share button to open up the share window again. And as you can see here now, it says shared with, and you see a little icon for John Jumbo, and there would be more here if there were other people. But if I click on that, it's going to open up this window that lists my collaborators, And if I click on Manage All, it'll open up a new window where they will be listed. And in this permissions column here, for each of my collaborators, I can adjust their permissions. So I can make John Jumbo an editor if I feel like it's appropriate. And it'll do that for me and save my changes. Or I could go ahead and remove him from this folder. And then it's going to ask me if I'm sure I want to do that. So I'm going to click on OK. And once I do, now you can see he's no longer listed here. So that's invites in a nutshell. Another thing that you can do, as we said earlier, is you can set up your shared links. So for this folder now, I can click on the share button again. And to set up a shared link, I click on this slider here to enable the shared link. Box is going to randomly generate a link for me. So you see the randomly generated texts and the numbers and letters here at the end of this URL. And if this is good to go, I could just go ahead and click on copy, and then I can paste that into an email or into a website. But you want to be careful about your shared links, because by default, at first, these links are publicly accessible. So you can go ahead and you can play around with the settings of these things to make them more restrictive. So what do I mean by that? Here, if I click on people with the link, I see that there are options. The default is that anyone with the link can access this content, which is maybe, you know, sometimes appropriate, but not always. If I want to, I can select people in the company, which means that only people who have the link and have a Tufts login can access the content. Or if I want to make this really, really restrictive, if this is content with some sensitive information, I can say that the link is only accessible to invited people. And what that means is that the only people who can access the content through the link are people who I have invited to that item, to that file or folder up here, or people who have already been invited to a parent folder for that item. So that's a great thing to do if you know you want to make it really secure. So I'm going to go ahead and change this back to people with the link. And another option that I have here for my link is I can decide if I want to give people the ability to either view and download the content or view the content only. So you can restrict that downloading capability. And finally, if I click into this link settings box, there are some other options that I can play around with as well. So if I want to, I can set an expiration date for this link. And what that does, let's say I choose Wednesday, June 5th, 2019. What that would do is it would cut off access through the link on that day. So people couldn't click on it and get to that item anymore. I can also password protect my link. And when I do that, people would have to put in this password in order to gain access to the content. So I would have to share the password with them through an email or, you know, something else. I can also set up a non-private custom URL here by checking on this box. And what that does is it gives people the ability to access the content through a URL that, instead of having the randomly generated numbers and letters here that box had for me, I can put in my own ending for the URL. So they give you some rules here. It's got to be 12 or more characters. They also recommend that you don't do this when you are sharing sensitive content, because custom URLs are a little bit easier to guess. But just to show you what that would look like, if I click into this box and I say, you know, this is a test for Brian here, what it does is it puts that text at the end of my URL. So now this is the link that people would click on in order to access that file or folder. And finally, down here, again, I can choose whether or not I want to give people the ability to download the content that is accessible through the link. And once you've made your changes here, make sure you click on Save so you don't, you know, lose those changes. And now that I've made my changes, I could go ahead and click on copy, and then I can paste that link wherever I want so that people can access it. Thank you for watching this video on sharing and collaboration within Box. If you'd like more information, you can go to the Box service page at access.tufts.edu/box.